Hey tubers, this is Big Kid, archersfriend.com, bigkidreviews.com. I'm going to start finishing out the floor of a trailer. I had a video some time ago before we moved back to Texas, and we replaced all these great big rough cut boards with northern Utah lumber, and left what's out of there now. I left that so we could go on and get moved. And then a week ago, it was looking pretty bad, and we had to, I walked on it a little bit, and it felt pretty spongy. Got a big pry bar out and hit it, just not much force, and poked a hole right through the board. So it's time to consider getting the thing replaced. I had that hoist mounted to the bed back here on the left side. So went on, ripped all them boards off, took off that hoist, and it probably isn't going to get to go back. But we'll see what happens. And I got still got to grind these bolts off. And then instead of going back with wood, I'm mighty tired of replacing that wood, although I've only done it twice and since I've had it. It's been several years, but still. The big thing here is to use what's called C Perlin. That's kind of a structural steel for your metal buildings, but that's what's going to be the floor. And then they put that roll-on bed liner stuff, kind of like a rhino liner, but you can do it yourself on there and for the non-skid. And every time people have to replace the boards down here, well, they go ahead and do the metal, and then you're done for a long, long, long time. So that's what we're going to start doing. Maybe a two-day project, I don't know. But anyway, I'll make a few clips along the way, see how it goes. Okay, well, we're back. After getting that first one on that far side done, which was a son of a gun because I had to notch both ends and finagle it and coax it to get under that lip on both ends. Got that in there, and then the next three went reasonably good, but they haven't been welded yet because I wanted to see how they were going to fit. So I'm going to wait until tomorrow to do that. My back says I've had plenty to do today. All right, we'll be back tomorrow, and I'll start trying to weld it without crowding myself into a corner. See you on the next clip. Well, look, another clip. Update. I got two pieces welded in, and then if you can see along there, I've had to put washers to level it up. These cross members are not lined flat from side to side or front to back for whatever reason. Well, for one thing, they don't go to the trouble to cut them. They stick a small channel inside a big channel, so then you got an eighth of an inch or more gap, and so I'm welding washers to try to level it up. I got two more to go, and I'll make another clip when I get more done. See you on the next clip. Well, I'm gonna call it good. The last two I didn't have room to get in there and weld, so I've got them tacked at the back and the front, and that last rail on the side is tucked under that 3-inch angle there, and the 2-inch angle up there, and then welded to the frame, top frame part. A whole lot better than it was. I'm pretty confident that nobody will step through it. These other boards can stand a little coat of oil or paint or something. Well, that's how we do it now, is to fix floors, is to put C Perlin instead of all this wood and all that drilling. See you on the next video. Hit that subscribe button.